لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا
وأذن في الناس بالحج يأتوك رجالا وعلى كل ضامر يأتين من كل فج عميق وأتموا الحج والعمرة لله فإن
إلهنا ما أعد لك مليك كل من ملك لبيك قد لبيت لك لبيك إن الحمد لله
الحمد لله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله ومن والاه. Respected brothers and sisters, inshallah we will be conducting our final episode. I'll start again. So you know this is here. I'm going to start again. الحمد لله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله ومن والاه. My respected brothers and sisters, inshallah this is the final episode of our Call for Hajj series. Inshallah in this episode we are going to reflect upon Hajj Mabroor. What is the difference between Hajj Mabroor and Hajj Maqbool? We don't even want to maybe delve into Hajj Mardood. We make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not have any of our Hajj rejected. And inshallah, alhamdulillah, all of us inshallah are going with sincerity for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to do Hajj, and inshallah all of us are coming out of our Hajj with Hajj Maqbool. But we want to make an effort to raise the status of our Hajj, hopefully to a Hajj Mabroor. So, my respected brothers and sisters, why am I saying that inshallah all of our Hajj will be accepted? Imam Hassan al-Basri rahmatullahi alayhi says, he says in one of his manfuzat, one of his sayings, if I know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has accepted even one good deed of mine, even one good deed of mine, then I am confident inshallah that by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I will enter Jannah. Subhanallah. If I am confident that Allah has only accepted one good deed of mine, then I am confident that inshallah by the mercy of Allah I'll enter into Jannah. So inshallah all of us left our homes, we utilized our wealth, we utilized our time, our energy, moved away from our families for a couple of weeks so that we can do this Hajj. Inshallah it will be a Hajj Maqbool. So what is the difference between Hajj Maqbool and Hajj Mabroor? Hajj Maqbool is an accepted Hajj. It will make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts each and every single one of our efforts and accepts our Hajj. Hajj Maqbool means I came for Hajj, I did Hajj the way inshallah it has to be, I tried my best and I made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept my Hajj, and Allah accepted my Hajj. Now, Hajj Mabroor is one step further than that. Hajj Mabroor is I came for Hajj, I did Hajj the way it ought to be inshallah, I asked Allah to accept my Hajj, and Allah inshallah accepted my Hajj, but I took my Hajj from Hajj Maqbool to Hajj Mabroor. How did I do that? All of the promises that I gave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and each and every single mu'min that comes for Hajj promises Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala many things. Like, Ya Allah, I will not turn to sin again. Ya Allah, I will not backbite again. Ya Allah, I will not do such and such deed again. So it's us holding our end of the bargain. Hajj Maqbool is there. If we want Hajj Mabroor, what we promised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we will not engage in, we continue to not engage in that. Or we promise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to engage in, we will inshallah continue to engage in that. You know, I'm missing my Fajr Salat. Ya Allah, when I go back from our Hajj, Ya Allah, in these 14 days of Hajj and Umrah and going to Medina, or 21 days, I never missed any Fajr. Inshallah, I'm going to continue praying Fajr. Ya Allah, you know, I have found myself that negligent of the Qur'an. I read the Qur'an, Surah Al-Kahf, only on Fridays, but I don't read Qur'an throughout the week. Inshallah, when I go back, I'm going to continue reading the Quran throughout the week. Every day I'll sit down, I read the Quran at least 2 pages, for example. So these are our promises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what we're going to do. So Hajj Mabroor means there's two ways to look at it. Hajj Mabroor, what I promised Allah I will do, I will continue doing. At the same time, I promised Allah that I won't do certain things. For example, I promised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, you know, Ya Allah, I have this problem, Ya Allah, and you know what's in the hearts, that I just can't stop myself from backbiting. I just love gossip. I just can't stop myself from backbiting and gossiping. Ya Allah, I have a problem with controlling where my eyes look and what my eyes are looking at. Ya Allah, I have a problem in terms of having extramarital relations. This is a very common thing nowadays, especially with our young folk. Ya Allah, I'm not going to engage in that. So we are holding up that end of the bargain as well. While holding up the end of the bargain, we make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, you accept my Hajj, I will engage in such and such deeds. And Ya Allah, accept my Hajj, I will not engage in such deeds. So holding up those both ends of the bargain. If I can give you another example, the example is from the hadith of Rasulullah when he spoke about Ihsan. He was asked the question by Jibreel alayhi salam, that what is Islam? Jibreel salam explained the fundamental of Islam, the outwardly actions. He was asked a question by Jibreel salam, what is Iman? He explained what Iman was. And then he was asked a question by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that what is Ihsan? What is Ihsan? What is excellence? So the Prophet replied, أن تعبد ربك كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. So he said that Ihsan has two levels. Ihsan at both levels are amazing and they're good, alhamdulillah. But there are two levels to it. One of the levels is أن تعبد ربك كأنك تراه, that you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if you can see Allah in front of you. And he described a second level of Ihsan was if you cannot see Allah when you're worshipping Allah and you're not so conscious of Allah that as if He's in front of you, then worship Allah knowing that He is watching you. Respected brothers and sisters, the difference is some of us, may Allah give us tawfiq, if we reach a certain level of taqwa, like the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, then we're worshipping Allah and we continue our day every single day as if Allah is watching us. And for some of us, if we can't reach that level, the minimum, the Prophet is saying of Ihsan, is that Allah, that we worship Allah as if Allah is watching us. Respected brothers and sisters, if I give you an example, one is, you know, my teacher is in front of me and tells me, don't do this. And I can see my teacher is looking at me. And now I'm conscious that, you know, my teacher is in front of me. I'm like, there's no way I can do this. One is, I'm sitting at a certain, for example, corner of the classroom. And my teacher, of course, is still there in the classroom. But I feel like maybe he can see me. The difference between two Ihsan is the person sitting in front of the teacher, directly in front of the teacher is looking at him, he's looking at the teacher. And the other person sitting in the corner of the classroom where he thinks, not thinks, he knows the teacher can see me, yet maybe, you know, I might be able to get away with something here and there. May Allah give us tawfiq to be that first level of Ihsan. And that is you literally live your life as if everywhere you go, you see Allah is watching you and Allah is seeing you. And that second level is a level where you're conscious that Allah is watching me. But it's not at the level that Allah is right in front of me and watching me. Prophet is not saying that, na'udhu billah, Allah is standing there in front of you. He's giving you that two level of Ihsan. Now, what the difference between the two of them are. One is you feel as if you can literally see Allah everywhere you go. And you're conscious of that. And the second one is, You feel that Allah is watching you at each and every single moment of your life. So my respected brothers and sisters, moving that into Hajj Maqbool and Hajj Mabroor, both of them are good. Hajj Maqbool, Allah inshallah accept all of our Hajj. It's perfect, that's good. I'm now starting with a clean slate. I have literally zero sins inshallah as I'm leaving the haram. Alhamdulillah. But after Hajj Maqbool, if now I continue with my previous life, then I'm going to refill that clean slate with more and more and more sins. And the worst is if I continue to do the sins that I was doing in the past as well too, which I promised Allah I will not engage in. Hajj Mabroor is I'm leaving the haram, inshallah, with a clean slate. But I'm also making an effort to uphold my promise to Allah, to engage in certain things and continue engaging it, and upholding my bargain with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to not engage and not involve myself with certain things that I ask Allah to forgive me from. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq, inshallah. One and all, may Allah make us among those, inshallah, who when we leave Hajj, when we leave, inshallah, from our Hajj, we are leaving with not just Hajj Maqbool, but Hajj Mabroor. And in our daily lives, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the category of people, وَعَبُّدْ رَبَّكَ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ فَإِنْ لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَاهُ فَإِنْهُ يَرَاكَ. That level of ihsan, that we are conscious of Allah as if we can see Allah in front of us. And may Allah give us tawfiq, inshallah, one and all. I hope that inshallah throughout these series you had a better understanding of from a spiritual point of view and from a practical point of view what you can expect in Hajj and what inshallah we need to engage in Hajj. May Allah give us tawfiq, one and all. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable all of those who are listening to this to be able to complete their Hajj, inshallah. May Allah enable yourself and your families to be able to complete Hajj. And may Allah enable you that even after you complete your Hajj, that you continue to visit the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as much as possible. My respected brothers and sisters, you know, we there are many things in our lives that we aspire and that we work towards. And I often tell people, alhamdulillah, that we live in an era that, you know, Hajj has become extremely, extremely simple. Sometimes you get scared. You think, is Hajj so simple nowadays that, like, you know, it's like, will Allah accept our Hajj? That's how simple it has become. Sometimes you know, in your mind you have this question. Of course Allah will accept it, but that's how simple it has become. And you think about even 50 years ago, 30 years ago, how difficult, how challenging Hajj was, and how easy it is right now. At the same time, also we live, this is also a ni'mah, that Allah has made Hajj easy. Allah has made coming to the land of Hajj and Umrah easy for us. May Allah give us tawfiq to make that a part of our life. That, you know, every few years, I want to go back and visit the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ameen, ya Rabbul Alameen. If I have said anything in these series that has offended anyone, I want to seek, inshallah, your forgiveness in advance. And if anything good, inshallah, has come out of this, then it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah give us tawfiq wa anal. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
سأقبل يا خالقي من جديد كما أنت مني إلهي تريد وأرجو إذا أنت تقبلني جنان الخلود ومنك المزيد.